So I believe I told you guys that I'm doing a mini room transformation coming up. I don't have the funds to make my room pretty yet, and that's okay. But I do have the energy today to remix it and get it ready for what I'm trying to do. Yeah, it's just, it's tired, it's messy, it's depressing. Like, I've been home since May 2021 when I graduated school, moved back home. But the summer before I went to my freshman year of college, my parents moved houses. So I didn't really grow up here in this house. This wasn't like my room that I grew up with. I always had the idea that when I graduated college, I was gonna leave and not come back, or I'd be home for like a summer and then I'd be gone. And so I was never really invested anything into this room. Like, I never thought of it as anything other than a guest room. And so then my parents was like, okay, so you got your full-time job now, so we're gonna start asking you to pay rent. I was like, well, if I'm gonna pay rent here, I should start making this room into something that I'm actually genuinely comfortable in and gives me that type of mental release and creative flow of energy, and just like, it's my room. So yeah, today we're just gonna move furniture around. Future Ray, have fun editing this. Bye.
This is the layout of the room from the door over, closet, okay, bathroom. All right, so from bathroom over here.
In terms of the room, I need a wall for YouTube editing, so like a backdrop for YouTube editing. That's like the only requirement. To take out with me as I do the rest of it. All right, let's keep going. Oh, I cleaned these little walls here. I don't know, it just felt like it needed to happen. I don't even know if that was necessary. That sound was, I thought I was gonna go outside my door and see a dead man. I don't even remember stopping the video. And then he was like, it looks worse than it is. He was upside down. I can laugh about it now, because at first I was like, what the hell? Like, are you dead? Is he okay? After he said he protected his head, I was like, bet. I was like, did I do something on the stairs? Like, cause I just walked up and down the stairs to get the vacuum. So I thought like I had left something, or like, I don't know. So I was like, oh my God, like somebody. Anyway, I'm about to continue on with the room transformation. But oh my God. The right position. Now I'm gonna see how I like it from way back here. So that mirror will be gone, remember that. I'm gonna have a corner mirror right here, like a bigger one that's gonna go right there. I guess phase two will get this here, because that's where it's gonna go next. And then my desk is going to go into this corner. I feel like my walls are green. My mom swears they are like whatever color she thinks, but it's wrong. The walls are like a teal green. And we're doing gold. I had just happen to have this gold mirror from college. I'm showing you guys my entire messy room, but I feel like once I get it in order, I can start like slowly buying things. Slowly buying things. Time to move the desk. This dress is about to be heavy as fuck. All this money, when I grew up, I had nothing. Filled with backstabbing, my whole life is disgusting. Can't believe it, gotta thank God that I'm living comfortably. Yeah, Jax, I don't believe what she says, she done with me. Burn some bridges and I let the fire light the way. Kicking my feet up, left the PJs on a PJ. Yo, I'm a big dog and I walk around with no leash. I got water on me, yeah, everything on Fiji. Suicide door, brand new. Okay, I'm not sure which boyfriend gave me this. I've only had two boyfriends in my life. And then there's this. Shout out to Bradley for breaking up with me before I bought tickets to a basketball game. And long story there, not really a long story there, short story there, but. Okay, so we were together. We were long distance. I was like 16, because I was able to drive. I was 16 years old and I bought him tickets for Valentine's Day, but I bought these tickets like November. I bought tickets to the Chicago Bulls Charlotte Hornets game because I knew he liked the Bulls. And then we broke up like around Christmas, New Year's, whenever. Texted me, said, he said, I don't want this relationship anymore. I need time to figure it out. A week later, we didn't talk for a whole week. A week later, he's like, yeah, I'm done. But he gave me this, which I don't even know how he fit this. I don't even know, I couldn't even wear this because I was taller than him, but he was like 5'11", and I was like 6'1", 6'2". And I don't even know how he fit this. But anyway, so he gave this to me, and I threw it away, thought I threw it away. No, I gave it to one of my old best friends. We were all three of us, we knew each other. So I gave it to her, I was like, keep it. I don't want to look at it anymore, but I don't want to throw it away. So she held on to it for me. And then when I went to see her like years ago, I got it back and I kept it. Just the memories, I like to keep shit like that. But I don't know who gave me this fish. So this could go. But first love, Bradley can get the little, he can get the little hoodie. I'll hold on to that or whatever. But this, I don't know who that belongs to. Shit. I got my welcome box. I figured I should tell you where I work now because you'll see it on my LinkedIn. So it's not a big deal. But I do hope that I can like share more about what I do. But we'll see. My mom was really excited. I was like air drying and like the doorbell rang and my windows are all open. So I like ducked. And then my mom, she was like, come see the box, maree. I thought she got me a computer or something because I was talking about my computer been broken. I was like, is it a Mac? She's like, girl, no, it's your belt. So I gotta show y'all the pictures. But... Oh! So right off the bat, we got this box. Oh, so cool. What? They already have my badge in here. Maree Johnson. You got a little notebook. You got mouse pad. I have a letter. This is so cool. Like, I feel like I got into college or something. Welcome to Belk. I have the onboarding guide. Wow. Oh my god, they give you like a nice like city notes to Charlotte. Oh, this is serious. What? Is it a mug? I love mugs. What's a nice mug? Yo, that is so cute. That is so cute. Oh, actually, before I forget, let me show you what the room is looking like, even though it's a mess now, but it was clean. So I moved, I did end up moving the desk in the middle of the room and the dresser's in the corner. And this is what it looks like. I actually really like it a lot, no cap. So now I have all this space. So like the TV is mounted, full length mirror, and my photos, and then like I record right here. And then my closet ended up looking like this in the end here. So yeah, shoes, bookshelf, I had to sneak back there. And yeah, this mirror still has to go. And the bathroom is next, which I dread doing because it's like, it's a lot. I have too many things. But yeah, man, so slow progress. The probably next time you see my room is when I'll have it all together. So this is kind of the end of the transformation. So today was my last day at Famous Toastery, my last weekday working as a server. Also, let me show y'all what I made. So I felt like I wasn't believing in myself enough. And so what do you do when you feel like you're not believing in yourself? You manifest, baby. Manifest. Right now we're sitting at a smooth 51 subscribers. So if you like me, you like what you see, not all this, but all this, please stay a while and help me get here. Join the family. I wouldn't be here without my friends. And then I wouldn't be here without my passion. And then I won't be here without y'all.
So don't kill it.
No.
Don't kill it. All right.
Get closer.
Wait, I want to see you do it.
Okay, no.
Exactly. How is it falling?
It's gonna fall straight down. Oh. You're gonna catch
straight
it.
Straight down?
Yes.
So I can just leave it there then.
Oh, that's big.
It's you.
start my job tomorrow. Isn't that like insane? I still don't think it's like hit me yet. Even unboxing the box, even in like trying to buy my clothes for this job, like it has not like, it hasn't.
A few moments later.
I think it's just starting to hit me that I work tomorrow. And I don't know, it feels like I'm going to a new school. Like I have no idea what to expect. I have zero expectations though. And that's like the crazy part. Like I have zero expectations. So I'm kind of speechless about the whole thing. Like I don't even know what to, I don't know. I just came back from Walmart where I bought some bathroom organization stuff and some energy drinks because I feel like I'm gonna need that throughout the week. And I finally brought some candles. Shit, I finally got them. My two favorite scents, sweet sugar lemon and vanilla. Fuck yes, yes. I bought these two like bathroom shelf things. I think I can set them on my bathroom counter and yeah, I'm gonna organize that. And now last but not least, I purchased 20 G's of lavender seeds. It is so strong too. My friend Jalil, shout out to him. He started smoking lavender because he didn't like the adverse effects of it. So he put me on to it, but after researching it and then seeing how it affected him, I think I'm gonna try it. And I can do this in my house. So yeah, I can smoke lavender in the house, probably. I have so much to do today. I have to clean my bathroom, straighten up my room a little bit. And after I do all of that, I will grind up my lavender and go to sleep. So this is the bathroom now. A little less chaotic. I use the desk organizer for that. My cabinet space are being a lot more. The cleaning supplies are in that bin back there. Shit I hardly ever use. Big shit that wouldn't fit. And then shampoos, some conditioners, bunch of creams, vitamins, oils, and these drawers are just full of like, they're a lot emptier now, which is like what I wanted, so. I can't believe I did it. like I can't believe I got this job. Like, I can't believe my first day is tomorrow. I literally fell in love with the job description. Like, everything about this job, like, sung out to me. It's crazy because during the last year of college, I kept saying, like, I am not going to go to corporate. I am not doing no fucking 9-to-5. Like, I will not be behind a desk. And here I am. I hope I make myself proud. And I hope that I take advantage of all the opportunities that come my way within this job. You really never know where things take you. I'm so grateful for this. I just cannot believe I'm here. Like, through all the post-grad depression, all the anxiety, all of the feeling like I would never figure out what I wanted to do, all the indecisiveness, all of the crazy conversations with my parents and my friends, and just not being able to properly articulate what I wanted, having these big ass dreams and big ass ideas, and feeling like I'm the only person that like could really see it, knowing this job was right for me and going after it and not settling for anything that came along the way. So yeah, I'm very grateful to me. Second person I'm grateful to is my best friend, because she's always seen a light. I remember my graduation day. She was the person I heard when I like walked by and the people that were sitting. She was the person I heard above everyone in the bleachers. And I looked up and I almost lost it. Like, I had to look away immediately. Like, there'll be so many, boy, there's gonna be so many moments of cheering for each other's successes. I appreciate it more than she'll ever know. And my parents, my family, through all of the passionate conversations we've had since I've been home, I wouldn't be where I am without them. And I wouldn't be placed in certain rooms, placed around certain people, understand how big the world is, understand how many opportunities there are out there for me without them making me believe that that was possible or giving me this lifestyle to where I believe I can shoot up. It was my mom once told me that she wishes when she was younger, she was able to know how much was out there. And I truly believe like she's done that for me 10 times over. I've never felt slighted. Anything I wasn't prepared for came from my own anxiety and like my own personal setbacks. It was never the environment I grew up in. I've always had great education, great environment, health, safe, all of that. I've never gone without. But it puts you in this one very, very, very spoiled mindset because I didn't know how much I have to go alone. Now, I didn't realize how much I have to do by myself. It's like that's like an overwhelming thought of how much it actually costs to breathe in society. But that's a whole different conversation. And finally, I want to thank YouTube. YouTube holds me accountable, bro. Like, I have been wanting to do this since I was a little kid. I'm finally here and I love this process. I love sharing my life. It helps me to romanticize my life and live as if I'm living in my own personal fairy tale. If you made it this far in the video, I appreciate you so much. If you take anything away from this, it's gonna be the cliche, always believe in yourself. Never settle. Even if you can't articulate your dreams, you know your dreams. You know exactly what you see for yourself in this world. And just listen to yourself. Listen to what you like and don't like. Listen to what like makes your heart race. Like listen to your body, listen to yourself. It always hurts the most. It is the most painful climb when you're almost to the end. They throw like a fucking rock at you when you're right about to reach the top. I promise you that's what happens. I believe in you, just like you believe in me, because you made this far in the damn video. So thank you so much. My watch time, thanks to you. We're on the road to 100,100 subscribers. So subscribe. Thank you so much to my 51 subscribers that I have right now. It's incredible that 51 of you are tuning in. Bye, guys.